Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemy.
This is Naveen and part of the instructor team at MakerDemy.
In this episode, you'll learn about the last will and testament feature of MQTT and why it is important. Last will and testament is not a word that you usually come across in the world of technology, and yet is an important feature of MQTT. Before we dive deep into the nitty-gritty details of this specific feature in MQTT, let's understand the terminology first. To do that, for a brief instance, we need to beam out of the world of machines and into the world of people. In this world, a last will and testament is a legal document written by a person while he or she is alive that communicates a person's final wish pertaining to distribution of possessions. The person will also name a still living person in the will to carry out the instructions once he or she dies. As you have clicked on this video, I would assume that you would already know some basics of MQTT. As you know, MQTT provides an alternative to traditional client-server architecture by introducing a publish-subscribe model. In this model, the decoupling of publishers and subscribers is done by introducing a third component called broker in between them. This decoupling is the reason for many of the great features of the MQTT protocol. In short, because of the decoupling, the broker handles most of the logic and filtering, which allows the client application to have a tiny footprint. This is very useful for small and constrained IoT devices, which is often the use case of MQTT. MQTT is often used in scenarios that include unreliable networks. Thus, it is reasonable to assume that at some point or another, some of your MQTT clients will disconnect ungracefully. Usually, if the client wants to disconnect from a broker intentionally, it will send a disconnect packet to the broker. But if a disconnect happens due to loss of connection, empty batteries, hardware failure, or any such reasons, then the broker won't be getting a disconnect packet. This is called an ungraceful disconnect. Due to the decoupling nature of the MQTT architecture, the other clients who have subscribed to a published topic of the disconnect client will not know about the ungraceful disconnect. This is where the last will and testament feature of MQTT comes into the picture. Each client can specify its last will message when it first connects to a broker. The last will message and its properties are all sent in the connect packet itself. The connect packet will include the last will message topic, the last will message itself, the last will flag, and the message quality of service and retain message flag. The broker stores the message until it detects the ungraceful disconnect. In response to the ungraceful disconnect, the broker sends the last will message to all subscribed clients of the last will message topic. On the other hand, if the client disconnects gracefully with disconnect message, the broker will discard the last will and testament message that is stored. So let's connect this feature back to the real-life analogy we discussed earlier. The broker is like the executioner of the last will, and all the notified clients are like the children or close family of the deceased. So let us look at a real-world scenario where last will and testament will be very useful. This will help you to internalize the concept much better. Let's say your company has installed a smart HVAC system in a factory and it consists of an array of hundreds of airflow and pressure sensors distributed throughout the HVAC pipes. If a sensor node is damaged, has battery failure, or has network issues, due to the decoupling nature of the MQTT architecture, the subscriber clients can't know which board has ungracefully disconnected. It will be a pain to manually find the sensor node and replace it. This issue could have been easily solved if the system had used the last will and testament feature of MQTT. Let's see how. All the sensor nodes on its first connection to the broker will set the last will message as sensor ID to a topic called sensor/offline. Let's say we have two subscriber clients, one for HVAC control dashboard in the factory and another is an emergency SMS notification client. Both of these clients are subscribed to the same last will message topic. Thus, now when a sensor disconnects ungracefully, the broker will forward the sensor ID of the specific node to both the clients. One client will show the details on the dashboard, while the other client will send an SMS to the concerned staff. With the sensor ID information, technicians can easily find and replace or repair the specific sensor node. With this example application, we believe that you have understood the last will and testament feature of MQTT and its importance. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.